Hey guys, doing some more work on the server. I've had it running for a few days. I've had no problems with it, so it's good to go. The only problem is we have to get rid of this OEM power supply. As you can see, it's too big this way, as well as this way, and I don't feel like modifying a new case to fit this power supply, because if it dies, then I basically have to look for the same one. Okay, so basically I went online and I found a diagram to help you modify this HP power supply that's OEM to a standard ATX. This one here is one I used in the past for testing. It needs to be fixed up, but we're going to use it to test to see if it'll at least power up the board. This is a standard ATX. Now if you look at the plug in this direction here with the pin on this side, the bottom pins, or the bottom wires, as you can see, are nothing but 12 volts, all yellow. Three yellow here, and one yellow over here. And this one, the standard ATX, on this side, it's red instead of yellow, and down here, the orange instead of yellow. So what you're going to do is you're basically just going to cut the orange, leave a little bit of length on it, like right there, and cut the red, leave a little length on it, and then cut the yellow. So cut all three of them, okay? That's what we'll do. Let's cut into those wires and join them together, see what happens. So, let's see. The red, orange, and this will basically turn all of them into 12 volts. And that's basically it. There is one more wire that would normally be here. It's a negative 5 volts that would be white. But on this power supply, it doesn't have it. So all the grounds are pretty much tied together. So we don't really need it. So am I doing this right? Oops. No, I'm not. All you need is to strip the yellow one. And then strip all three of these. And it basically turns the 3 volts and the 5 volts into 12 volts plus. And then we'll just wrap these together. And the yellow goes to there. What we'll do is we'll shoot a little piece of shrink wrap on it. Too short, too small. This would probably work. By the time you shrink it down, it should be alright. Now I don't know if this PSU even works. It's the last one I have in the shop, so all my other ones are taken. There. Let's quickly shoot some solder on that and see if it actually works. Either works or blows the computer up, which I will not be happy about. Oh, you see me working on my motor here. Not fun. Let's get some stuff out of the way here. Yeah, so right now I have Plex and a file server that runs in Windows, and it runs pretty good over the network for now. I'm thinking of running something more professional on it, but for now, through my network only, it's fine. So that what you're seeing here is pretty much the HP mod. It's just basically, if you go by the instructions I showed you, which way the pin or the socket is and which wires to cut, and that's it. Like I said, you might have that negative 5 volts, which is white. And that one's supposed to be cut and grounded, so... do I have a lighter around here? Actually, let's not even do that. Let's, make sure none of these wires are touching, obviously. And let's do a quick test just to see if it'll even power the board up. These two are not going to short. Everything else checks out. Now, if this doesn't work, it doesn't mean it's my wiring. It's probably this power supply. Green light. Is good. Yep, power's up. I'm not getting all the fans though. Oh, I wouldn't. The I didn't plug the CPU header in. This one here, the short one that I gotta actually I have to test that. Okay, so I pinned this one out, and when I test the CPU power supply or lead, I get 12.16 volts. Okay, so we'll quickly test the other one. Powered up. Oh, gotta plug it in. Doi. Touching once again. We're going to put new leads and everything on it once I know it's working. And this one comes up. Well, it's not 12, but it's not anything higher than that. So it'll probably work. We'll just take a look at the, make sure the grounds and everything are the same, which they are. Instead of white, it's brown. That's the only difference. So let's shut this down. So this is... If we mod this out, I'm going to have to extend this wire. It's way too short. Especially if I get the new server case. Yikes. That's scary. Whoa. Yeah, this is... This is not good. Alright. Sketchy. No smoke. There we go. It's got, both fans are going, so it's got full power, and we have post. Oh, there we go. So there you go. That's a standard ATX working on a HP Z400, which is nothing. You don't really need to do the extra ground. Just if there is a white wire there, just cut it. That way, because it's a negative 5 volts. I'm going to run it, and actually I'm going to run something well, maybe it won't work. Oh, the hard drive's not plugged in. Anyway, I know it is posting, or I know it is working, so I gotta redo all the wiring harness on it, and then we'll do another test on it. So I went and raped all the wires off the OEM power supply. I'm not gonna really need it for much of anything anyway. It's got decent fan and that in it. You could use it as a bench power supply for testing stuff. I stole the 12-volt lead off of it, or the 11. Yeah, I made it twice as long, shrink wrapped it. That way we don't, it'll fit in the case. I'm not too sure if this one's gonna fit still. Shrink wrap that, so that's ready to go. And then I added this one to it. I got more to, I can add to it if I want. I just cut the leads off for now, so it'll short. And I got a couple of SATA connectors here to get me up and running. Got at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so. That should be enough to see if this will even boot up.
As you can see, now it reaches. What else? Leave it there. We only need to plug in the hard drive right now. Sorry about the mess here. I actually came down here to clean up, and then I started doing this. This is how projects get started. I just wanted this out of the way, so like when I get the case here in about a week or so, I'm up and running. I'm ready to go. I don't have to do anything else. All right, nothing is shorting or touching. Power. Yep. And you got power. Hard drive spinning up. Yep. Let's take a look here. Now, if you pull the, unless you steal the connectors off the case, it's always going to give you that error. Well, looks like it's going to boot. I'm hoping this power supply can handle it. What I should actually do is I should throw like 4 or 5 hard drives on it just to see if it, can keep up. So we might have a we might have the power supply that'll go in the case. But also, you should label that if down the road, if you decide to use that in a different project, you don't want to be plugging it into a standard ATX power supply motherboard, because you'll blow it up for sure. Because now you got the leads that have the 3 volts plus 3 volts. Plus 5 volts are both 12 volts, so yeah, you'll definitely blow a board up with it. If I have anything here I could run on it to test the put it under load. I got Furmark. I can try that. It's gonna take a minute though. It's still loading. Everything else. GPU burner doesn't work because I don't have the driver for that card yet. Oh, do I? No, I do not. Or do I? It's a different card. Oh, I do. Sweet. Oh, just do that. That'll definitely stress out the power supply. She's just checking the heat. I don't hear any coal whine from the PSU, and it doesn't seem to be getting really hot, so I think we're good. We're really good. I got extra leads in case I need them. If I decide to put a better graphics card in, or more hard drives. But like I said, there's like 5 or 6 SATA connectors there anyway, so. Alright, we're ready for the case. I'll post a video once it comes in. Later, guys.